foreseeing that we have this ministry.
All you got to do is
as we have received mercy, we faint not, but have renounced the hidden things of dishonesty, not walking in practice, nor handling the word of deceitfully, but by manifestation of the truth, commending ourselves to every man's conscience in the sight of God. But if our gospel be hid, it is hid to them that are lost, in whom the God of this world has blinded the minds of them which believe not, lest the light of this glorious gospel of Christ, who is in the image of God, to shine unto them. For we preach not ourselves, but Christ Jesus the Lord.
Somebody can go with me. Oh, of this land. Hallelujah. No, 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 can somebody identify? Give me a clean heart, Lord Jesus, so that I Woo! right there. Give it to me, Jesus. Give it to me, Master. I want you to raise your hand like it may be your last time. I need a clean heart. Hey, Jesus, can you hear me? I need a clean heart. If you were to come right now, I'm not ready, but give me a clean heart, Jesus. Woo! I said, give me a clean heart, Jesus. I said, give me a clean heart, Master. Right now, right now, right now. Ooh! Ooh! Woo-hoo! Give me a clean heart, and I'll follow thee. Together. Thank you, Lord.
When you're lonely and your heart is filled with despair, remember God cares. And when you're in doubt and you can't find your way out, He will see you through. Yes, He will.
I'm wondering if there's still power in that name. Beginning at verse 11, and we will read down to verse 16. Acts 9, 11 through 16. Let's read together. And the Lord said unto him, Arise, and go into the street, which is called Straight, and inquire in the house of Judas for one called Saul of Tarsus. For behold, he prayeth, and has seen in a vision a man named Ananias coming in and putting his hand on him that he might receive his sight. Then Ananias answered, Lord, I have heard by many of this man how much evil he has done to the saints at Jerusalem. And there he has authority from the chief priests to bind all that is called on thy name. But the Lord said unto him, Go thy way, for he is a chosen vessel unto me to bear my name before the Gentiles, the kings, and the children of Israel. For I will show him how great things he must suffer for thy name's sake, amen, the word of God. But the Lord said unto him, Go thy way, for he is a chosen vessel unto me, to bear my name before the Gentiles and kings and the children of Israel, for I will show him how great things he must suffer for thy name's sake. To continue our series and our theme, to know him and to make him known. Tell two people around you, just say, who me?
Who
Who, me? Acts chapter 9 and 8, 9 and 10 gives the conversion of three different individuals, and their whole commission was to know him and then to make him known. When we get to chapter 9, we have a brother named Saul, a Judaizer, one who studied the Jewish law, was familiar with all the sacrifices, all the rituals. He had heard about this man named Jesus who had caused some of his disciples to come over on the Lord's side. Got pretty angry with that because this revival was hitting all the different cities and he wanted to put a stop to it. Saul. He had even reached a point where he was getting a letter so he can persecute everybody who called upon the name of the Lord. But something happened. I just want to share with you that all of the energy that he used to tear down the church, when something happened on the road to Damascus, the same energy that he used to tear down the church, now he's going to use that same energy to fulfill the commission that God has put in his way. Sometimes it's kind of hard for me to understand because I've seen some of you in the world. And some of us remember Saturday night when you just got in time to come to church. And I know some of you remember because it was just last night that it happened. There is a Saturday night. And how many remember your Saturday nights? How many of you remember going to a house party and it was hot? And you stayed. Well, God is going to take this brother who persecuted the church. Now he's going to use him to build up the church. Chapter 9, let's go through it so you can walk through the journey with me. And Saul, yet breathing and threatening and slaughter against the disciples of the Lord, went unto the high priest and desired of him letters to Damascus, to the synagogues, that he, if he found any of this way, highlight of this way, because that's what believers were called before they became Christians. They were called of the way. And I just think that St. John chapter 14, when he says, I am the way and the truth and the life. So we were children of the way before they start calling us Christians. That if he found any of this way, whether they were men or women, he might bring them bound unto Jerusalem. And as he journeyed, he came near Damascus, and suddenly there shined around about him a light from heaven. And he fell to the earth and heard a voice saying unto him, Saul, Saul, why persecutest thou me? And he said, Who art thou, Lord? And the Lord said, I am Jesus, whom thou persecutest. It is hard for thee to kick against the pricks. Believers, remember that when you are persecuted for righteousness' sake, it's not you they don't like. It's the Jesus in you that they have a problem with. So stop getting on the defense when folk don't care about you because you name the name of Christ. Don't take it personal. Because if Jesus wasn't in you, they wouldn't have anything to complain about. Because sometimes we think that people are just out against us. They're not against you. They are against the Christ that's in you. Because if it wasn't for Christ in us, we'd be regular old, you know the word. We'd just be regular old people. But because of Christ, I am what I am because of Christ. Verse 5, I am Jesus. That's where they made the mistake. Because you can talk about the man upstairs all you want. People not going to bother you. You can talk about a prophet. Not going to bother you. Matter of fact, the three major religions, Christianity and Judaism and Muslims, we can agree on a lot of things. We can agree on the law, we can agree on the prophets. What changes everything is when you start talking about Jesus. Now they believe he was a good prophet, and some are still waiting for him to come. But those of us who name the name of Christ know that Jesus is the Son of the living God. And Jesus is God in the flesh. So when you start talking about Jesus, that's when we have the problem. And he said, Who art thou, Lord? And the Lord, it is amazing to me that he even recognized him as Lord, but had not received him as Lord. So everybody who raises a hand or shout glory could be just imitators. Some can jump in the dance just because somebody else is doing it. But you need to know that he is Lord. People don't have a problem making him Savior. They have a problem making him Lord. Because, yes, you are grateful that he saved you from your sins. You praise God for that. But when he becomes Lord, then he starts directing your life. And if he's directing your life, how many times do you know that he has to redirect you? Because this is the way you really want to go, and the Lord says, no, you need to turn and go this way.
And then you know when he's Lord, when you follow his direction. We all can shout off a Savior. Everybody can't shout off a Lord. Because you can't have your own way when he becomes Lord. And yes, you want to be just like everybody else. And sometimes you want to be carnal like everybody else. But the Lord, when he directs your life. How many of you know that you don't have to be around people to be convicted? How many of you know the Lord can convict you in your private time? How many of you know he can convict you while you're getting ready to do something wrong and you know it's wrong? He won't even allow you to enjoy what you're getting ready to do because he is Lord of your life. It would be better, you say, Lord, I appreciate you being Savior, but I don't know about this Lord business. You're not walking in the Word until he becomes Lord. How many have been convicted this week over something? I know I didn't see all the hands because some of you should have just been convicted over lying. Because no one in this place have arrived. And there's sometimes I think, Lord, I can make it in right now. You know there are some things that he's asked you to do and you haven't done. He asked you to do some things, tell you not to do some things, and you've done them. So it's the sin of omission and commission. He'll get you going and coming. Make him Lord. Look at verse 6. And he trembling and astonished, and said, Lord, what wilt thou have me to do? And the Lord said unto him, arise and go into the city, that it shall be told thee what thou must do. And the men which journeyed with him stood speechless, hearing a voice, but seeing no man. And Saul arose from the earth, and when his eyes were open, he saw no man, but they led him by the hand and brought him into Damascus. Verse 9. And he was there 3 days without sight, and neither did he eat nor drink. How many of you know that God knows how to get your attention? Saul now, blind, can't see, he's praying, and he's fasting. And there was a certain disciple at Damascus named Ananias. And to him said the Lord in a vision, Ananias. And he said, behold, I am here, Lord. And the Lord said unto him, arise and go into the street, which is called Straight, and inquire in the house of Judas for one called Saul of Tarsus. For behold, he prayeth, and has seen in a vision a man named Ananias coming in and putting his hand on him that he might receive his sight. And Ananias answered, who, me? Lord, it's already rumored about this man named Saul. He don't like us. He wants to kill and put in jail everybody who calls upon his name. You want me? Who, me? Listen to his testimony. And Ananias answered, said, Lord, I have heard by many of this man how much evil he has done to the saints at Jerusalem. And here he has authority from the chief priest to bind all that call on thy name. And the Lord said unto him, go thy way. Who, me? Lord, I've already heard about him. I already know some things about him. This is what I like. And the Lord said unto him, go thy way, for he is a chosen vessel. You never know.